game one of the World Series tonight, as we have what is going to be a delicious pitching matchup as Max Scherzer takes on Gerrit Cole in game one of the Fall Classic. Again, every single pitch of the World Series you can hear right here on ESPN Radio. And I guess the question becomes, if you're the Nationals, are you going to play the where he's due theory? Because the last time we saw Gerrit Cole, look, he went seven innings, didn't give up a run.
But he could have been had, right?
He could have been had. He walked a career-high five batters. The Yankees loaded the bases in the first inning. They got two on in the second inning and just couldn't get that one hit. He has not lost a start since May. The team has not lost a start that Gerrit Cole has been on the mound since July, which are ridiculous numbers. Do we think it's sustainable, or do we think maybe finally, through that last outing, we're seeing some humanity.
I mean,
from
who
Gerrit
knows?
Cole.
You know, with the bottom line for what's Washington's thought process? Washington's in the World Series.
Yeah.
So they've done something right to get there. So it's basically we just keep going. You know, these guys are all going to go to the plate, understanding. You know, they all do their game planning just like they do in every sport. They'll know what they're looking for, just as Gerrit Cole and the pitching staff will do their game planning on what the hitters want. And we go from there. I mean, but the that stat to me is still amazing. Five of the top 10 pitchers in strikeouts in a regular season are in this World Series. That blows my mind. And let me ask you this question. If the Astros win it this year, it would be three consecutive 100-win seasons, including 107 this year, and they could win two of the last three World Series. If they do that, are we talking about them like Golden State?
Dynastic?
I mean,
it's fair.
Just well, because the thought is, again, they weren't talked about like in the beginning of the year, like Golden State is for the last few years of, well, they're going to be in the finals and probably win. Who's going to match them? But the Astros are talked about as, well, they're one of the best teams in the league, could easily be in the World Series again. I mean, we do talk about them in those terms.
Well, and they've got historic numbers to back it up. You guys ready for some nerd stuff? Let's get back in the nerd well. Man. You remember an oldie but a goodie here. It's our good offensive stat. Weighted runs created.
Oh, wait a minute. Yeah, Hold on.
It adjusts. It adjusts for ballparks. It adjusts for era. The Astros, again, I'm going to give it to you in terms you guys can understand, because weighted runs created plus might not do much for you.
Nope.
But they are the second best offense ever, according to that stat, behind only the 1927 Yankees. So
the Murderer's Row, yes. 1927.
The Babe
Gehrig,
Ruth, Lou Gehrig.
DiMaggio. Yeah. I mean, not DiMaggio, excuse
yeah.
me.
The Murderer's Row Yankees. So offensively, in that category, weighted runs created, they are second best to only them historically. So when you couple that with all of those other accomplishments and a bunch of names that we now know, because I'm with you, we don't talk about them like Golden State.
No.
Because baseball's a little harder than we talk about.
It
sell
is.
Those stars. But when you've got a rotation like this, when you've got Bregman and all these guys in the lineup that we're starting to get used to, because quite frankly, like him, Carlos Correa, these guys produce consistently enough in the postseason now to where, all right, we've seen them in the time of year where we're actually all paying attention.
Because you sit there and look at it, and you always look to the next year then. How much of the same guys do we have? We all figure Gerrit Cole's probably going to be gone. Making a
he's
couple
a free agent,
somewhere.
And I think he's from. I do.
Good call. Yeah. You got me.
Own it. He'll probably, he's a left coast guy. He'll probably end up back there. But I believe a lot of that lineup is going to remain the same. So, you know, you could be talking about them again this way next year.
Yeah, and it's interesting you bring up money in all this, because you're right. Like, going out tonight, Gerrit Cole is the surest bet in sports right now.
Yes,
and so I am going to ride with that guy until further notice. He is the Patriots and Alabama and UConn women's basketball, where you got to show me you can beat him before I'm going to believe it's humanly possible.
Correct.
But when you look at both these staffs in general, like, it shouldn't be that big a surprise. Of their big threes in pitching, so for the Nats, Scherzer, Strasburg, and Corbin, for the Astros, Verlander, Cole, and Greinke, they are 1 and 2 respectively of highest paid starters for their top three in the league.
Yeah.
So it is no surprise, much as we talk about in any sports, when you spend your money and you get it right like this,
good return on
you
investment.
Get a good return, yeah. Especially in a postseason where we've seen, whether you want to call it the ball or something else, or just the usual bout of better postseason pitching, we have seen runs down.
And again, in the NLCS, the starting pitchers for the Nationals had a 0.0 ERA. That's how good they were.
We're so glad you're watching ESPN on YouTube. For more sports and analysis, download the ESPN app. And for live streaming sports and premium content, make sure you subscribe to ESPN Plus. We'll see you there.